Conway Twitty tonight. Now, we don't want this necessarily to be a sad occasion. We want it to be more of a celebration. But still, it's really hard to describe what an enormous loss the country music community suffered when Conway Twitty died a year ago.
Yeah, he was doing what he loved best right up until the end. On Friday, June 4th, Conway played a 3 o'clock show in Branson, Missouri. Later in the day, he became ill while traveling on his tour bus and was rushed into surgery at a hospital in Springfield, Missouri. Now, the operation was a difficult one and revealed an abdominal aneurysm. Later on Saturday morning, Conway died of cardiac arrest.
It's still so hard to believe that he's gone. He had such an impact on all of our lives. His music touched people's hearts all around the world. And so what we'd like to do now is take a loving look back at his astounding career.
Mississippi like it was my own.
The earliest music Conway Twitty heard was the sound of riverboats along the Mississippi, for his father was a ferry boat pilot. At the age of 4, Conway was already learning to play guitar and sing. When he was 10, the family moved to Arkansas, where Conway formed a band he called the Phillips County Ramblers. Before long, Conway was hosting his own country radio show on station KFFA.
In high school, Conway was a star athlete, considering a pro career with the Philadelphia Phillies before Uncle Sam put him in uniform.
Lured by the excitement of Elvis Presley and rock and roll, Conway formed a band and in 1958 stormed the national pop charts with a song he wrote himself. Suddenly, Conway Twitty was a star.
Conway Twitty.
Even then, Conway's appeal to fans, especially female fans, was hard to miss. It wasn't long till Hollywood beckoned, but after a string of forgettable films, the singer decided to return to music, country music. Years later, he said he never regretted leaving rock and roll.
I had some million sellers, and I did all the things that I tried to do, but my heart was no longer in it, and if your heart's not in it, it ain't gonna last too long.
One of the best friends that a song ever had.
But rock's loss was country's gain. In 1970, Conway's career exploded a second time with a song that was destined to become his trademark.
Hello, darling. Nice to see you. It's been
Hello, darling was just the beginning. Hit after hit followed.
Lying here with Linda.
When he teamed up with Loretta Lynn in 1971, their duet magic merely enhanced Conway's own popularity.
Lead me on.
Yet despite his success, Conway never took his accomplishments for granted.
And so I've never been one to sit and look at things like that and say, boy, look at it, I did this and I did that, and that was great. The only thing I think about is that next record.
Over the years, Conway racked up 10 gold and 2 platinum albums, plus an astounding 55 number one hits, more than any other artist in history.
That's a lot of number one records. That's a lot. And a lot of years in business. A lot of things had to happen. A lot of people had to do a lot of things to make that happen.
Surprisingly, Conway won few industry awards, but in 1988, he received the Music City News Awards Living Legend Trophy and dedicated the moment to someone who's been with him since the beginning.
My mother's out there somewhere. Where is she? You see, Mama, I told you not to worry.
When he wasn't on stage, Conway loved relaxing at his 8-acre Twitty City estate just outside Nashville. He was the first country music entertainer to open his home to the public.
Conway, Arkansas, 25th.
Conway's constant companion was D. Henry Jenkins, his wife and business partner, who was by his side in 1990 when he celebrated his 25th anniversary in country music.
What do you say? I'm just glad the hell of darling.
Darling, I love to lay you down.
Far from slowing down, Conway seemed poised for another 25 years. In 1992, he was quick to deny rumors about his health after reports that he'd collapsed during a performance.
They even went so far as to have an arteriogram to make triple sure there's nothing wrong anywhere and everything's fine. I'm
as healthy as ever been in my life.
Few artists will ever leave a more indelible imprint on country music than the man born Harold Jenkins 60 years ago. He left a legacy of hits, a legion of admirers, and more friends than he ever knew.
Well, I'm my most fortunate person. Because I'm doing something I love to do, and able to take care of myself and all my family. That's one of the things I measure success by. You can do something you love to do and make a living at it. I don't care how much money you make, but if you love to do it, then you're on your way to being successful.
Earlier, when Conway first hit the big time, it was with a song that he wrote himself.
Well, nowadays this song is a classic. Here is Terry Mike Jeffrey with It's Only Make Believe.
They think you really